been heard speaking very highly of you. What's it like going against him?
It's been good so far. Obviously, he's a really good player. I mean, Coach Fry always says it's kind of like iron sharpening iron a little bit. So obviously, he gets the better of me sometimes. I get the better of him sometimes. And so it's been good for us to bring the best out of each other.
You said you're becoming a lot more technically sound.
Yeah.
Is that true?
Yeah, it's something I've had to focus on with a guy like Sosa. I mean, he's a big finesse guy. He has really good speed and skill for how big he is, and so he's a guy that you really have to step up your technique and your levels, or he's gonna capitalize on that.
How's Ty doing as far as kind of being the leader of the line there at center?
I think he's been doing a great job. I mean, he's been focusing on snaps still, obviously, but I think he's been a great job doing more vocal, kind of coming into his own. He's been a lot more confident than he was last year, and so it's been good to see that.
Offensive line took a lot of criticism last year. I know you didn't get much of that, but to talk about how maybe that drove you all over the winter and the spring and summer.
Yeah, I mean, it's obviously media isn't probably the first thing we think about, but it's obviously it's in the back of our minds, and so it's something we're trying to get better each and every day and kind of work on our craft and try and change that narrative.
What were some of the things you guys really needed to work on when you kind of looked back at that last season?
Consistency and probably mentality. I mean, a lot of times we were trying to just get by with stuff, or we were maybe kind of nonchalant, and so now we kind of have goals. We're set out. We want to be great, and that's kind of, I think that's kind of what's changing it so far.
Yeah, obviously it hurts to lose Noah early, but last year you guys were like, I don't know, had eight or so scholarship guys. Guys were dropping.
Yeah.
You know, were getting hurt even before camp started.
Yeah.
How do you feel about the depth and absorbing, loss of Noah or whoever, whatever might happen?
Oh, yeah, I think it's been good so far. I mean, obviously we've kind of had to cross train a little bit since Noah's been gone. I mean, I've played a little bit of tackle just more to ease some guys out. Kirby's played a little tackle. Even Ty's played some tackle reps just to kind of give some people a break. But it's been, I mean, it's kind of next guy up mentality. So some of the freshmen have been working in, and we're just trying to get by.
And you think that split fields things is working out, like in terms of helping out depth, going on two fields the way y'all are doing?
Yeah, I mean, from a depth perspective, it's nice because it allows us to get more reps. It allows people to work on their craft, get more on film so you can critique more and just get better. Obviously, doing split fields, you might have 8 and 8 for linemen, so you got to cross train a little more. But we're all getting reps, and it's all making us better. So,
for you as an offensive lineman, not wearing pads is probably the worst position to not have full pads. So what's it like to finally get everything on today?
It's nice. I mean, for us, even when we don't have pads on, it's almost kind of the same. But it's good to finally have kind of some of the leg pads on, kind of thump a little bit. I mean, I know we weren't live today, but it's good to have it all on, kind of feel how your steps are, feel how you're feeling it. I'm excited to see it get some live work tomorrow.
You dealt with a foot injury.
Yeah.
Coming out of school. What was the injury exactly?
It was a fifth metatarsal fracture.
Right. But you came back by the end of the spring.
Yes, sir.
You feel good 100% now?
Yeah, it feels good now. Yeah.
What about some of these young freshman offensive linemen? What have you seen from those guys?
They're grinders, and they're hungry. They want to learn. They're eager to learn. I mean, obviously, they're freshmen. They make freshman mistakes. They're not completely on the right path all the time. But we're just trying to kind of bring them along, and they're eager to learn, which is kind of the best part about it, and they're going to give you everything they have.
If you had to pick one of them who's standing out maybe above the rest right now, catching on earlier, who would you be?
I mean, they're all doing a very good job. I mean, I know Bo Limmer's kind of stepped in and do some center stuff, which has kind of stuck out to me just because he hasn't naturally really snapped the ball that much, so he's kind of having to learn some new stuff. But, I mean, Ricky's coming at guard, and he's done some really good things, even though he's only like 270 pounds. And Ricky Rathke moved out to right tackle, and he's been doing good. And they've all stepped up and done some really good things. But
who all's been working there since Noah's out? Obviously, you got Dalton over there. Who all's been working right there? He said you've been getting a little work.
Yeah, so Dalton's kind of the primary. He does some. Myron Cunningham will go out there a little bit when he's not doing left tackle. I'll do a couple reps just to give some people a break. Kirby did a couple. Ty did a couple. Dylan Rathke's kind of like the third right tackle right now, so he's been doing a pretty good job.
You guys lost 3 starters off the line. Obviously, Yelda was a pretty high draft pick, very versatile guy. But Dustin Fry was saying the other day, hey, the line's got to be better. Do you feel like it's realistic for you guys to be better, even losing 3 seniors like that?
I do. I think it's I think they did a really good job, and not just them, but the guys before them with, like, Frank and all them, of just kind of creating a mindset and passing it along, and that mindset grows as the classes get older. And so I think we have that mindset, we're hungrier, we have a bigger chip on our shoulder, and we're just kind of, I think, feel like we're more ready to go than we ever have been.
What kind of personal progression has been made? Is this kind of a long time?
For me, it was kind of, I've really been inconsistent since I first got here. And so for me, it's been, maybe a little bit more extra time on the field, maybe a little more extra recovery, a little extra time in the film room. It's been, for me, I've had to put a little more time into my craft. And it's paid dividends for me so far.
Hey, with Caps, I guess a year ago at this time, he was still on defense, I think. I mean, I know you're on the other side, but when you watch film and practice, how do you see him progressing? How's he doing now that he's been there for a year?
He's doing a great job. I mean, he's a guy that he's quick to learn. He wants to learn, and so it was good. I mean, when he first came over, the first reps he got at guard was in a scrimmage in fall camp, and so he was like, "What is going on?" But
we
didn't have much depth last year, so he was even going with like some of the ones and twos. But he's been great. I mean, he's really been working on his craft. Obviously, offensive line steps and technique is a lot different than defense, and so he's been really trying to get with that. I know he spends a lot of extra time with Fry in film rooms and just trying to work on stuff, and so he's been doing a great job.
I think last year, like I said, I think you maybe had 8 scholarship linemen at times, and this year you got 15 or 16 or 17 or whatever it might be. How different is that?
It's a lot different. Just you even go to a meeting and it's full, and it's like wild just to think about. I mean, I don't think we've had this many since I was a true freshman, which is crazy. But it's good to know that you have bodies there, you know, just to get reps. And it's good to not only watch yourself in film, but to be able to watch others and teach yourself off of others. And so it's good not only for me, but for everybody on the line, just kind of learn from each other.
In fact,